ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين.
تقال العثار العظام به ويعود الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر
time he uses the term al-musiba. Why? Because Allah is describing that as far as his qadr is concerned, as far as his planning is concerned, this was like an arrow that was shot and it was supposed to hit you exactly when and where and how deep and how badly, it was all decided. It is perfect hit. Perfect hit. Then the ta-marbuta also at the end of this word, we don't say musib, we say musiba. By adding a ta' marbuta, it adds the concept of al-hadath, meaning every single issue, every single thing. You know how you think, well, first thing that happened was my transmission went bad. Then the next thing that happened as a result was I was late to the meeting. Then the next thing as a result of being late to the meeting, I lost my job. Then as a result, I got divorced. Then as a result, then as a result, then as a result. There was a brother I met not too long ago who had some issue with his passport, and as a result of his issue, he lost his passport. As a result of that, he lost his job. And as a result of that, he got into arguments with his wife, and he blames the passport company, or the people that were applied for his visa. They cost me my marriage, they cost me my job, they cost me everything. So they tie all of these strings together, cause and effect, cause and effect, cause and effect. All of it is because of this one thing. And we do this too. But Allah Azza wa Jalla is calling each and every difficulty individual. They are not a result of each other, they are a result of Allah's allowance. Allah Azza wa Jalla allows every single one of those events to happen. There are people who go through exactly the same situation as you, but the same things don't happen. That chain of events doesn't happen, Allah decrees something else for them. So that's the first thing to note about the word musibah. It is specific, it is targeted to you. The two ayat, of the dozens of ayat, the two ayat that should never ever forget about the word musibah. Allah Azza wa Jal first of all says, in these ayat that I recited to you in Baqarah, He says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Congratulate the people who have sabr. What strange language Allah Azza wa Jal uses. When you and I have a difficulty, we're supposed to have sabr. You don't have sabr when you're happy. You're supposed to have sabr when you're upset, when something is wrong, when something goes badly. You were supposed to graduate, it got delayed, you didn't pass a class. You're supposed to have a little bit of sabr. You got sick, you're supposed to have sabr. Some bad thing happened and you're supposed to have sabr. Now you tell me, you and I, when we speak to each other and somebody is in a situation when they're supposed to have sabr, like you're in a situation or I'm in a situation where the advice is I should have sabr. You don't go to that person and say congratulations. You know, it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. Akhi, I feel terrible about what happened. I pray Allah gives you sabr. You don't smile at them, you don't congratulate them. Now when do you congratulate someone? You congratulate someone when there's a happy occasion, when things went according to plan, you applied for the job and the job came through and you got the job, you applied for a raise and you got a raise, you were looking to get married and the thing is settled. When things work out, then you congratulate each other. Look at the language of Allah Azza wa Jalla. He says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Congratulate the people who have sabr. SubhanAllah. Why? Because of the belief. For a believer, the attitude is entirely different. Maybe the whole ordeal, the entire trouble you are going through, the goal of it all was one thing. So you could have sabr. Because if you can have sabr, you are worthy of congratulations. We think the goal was this thing you were going to get in dunya. Maybe I thought the goal was to get the job. Maybe I thought the goal was to make the sale. But maybe to Allah, the real goal is you were going to learn sabr. That's a bigger goal than anything else. SubhanAllah. And if you got that goal, you should be congratulated. So we have goals in our head that we think we want to accomplish. We have things in our heart we want to accomplish. And Allah says there is something much more valuable in your heart. If you accomplish that, you don't even realize what it's worth. And I will tell you what it's worth congratulations. And then, right after this congratulations, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Who should you congratulate? These patient people who, whenever a specific target calamity difficulty hits them, the first thing that comes out of their mouth,
"Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un."
No doubt about it, we belong to Allah. "Wa inna ilayhi raji'un." No doubt about it, we are only going to be returned to Him.
Mm-hmm.